Mike, who did you look up to in the early years of your flying career?
As far as local people or something, or?
Or even, let's start with the local people. Who helped you in the early part of your career? You've already talked about one gentleman.
Probably this fellow worked for Jones and Laughlin Steel, Clem Thoman. And he lived, after I got out of the service, I got married and I moved down in the eastern section of New Orleans. And he lived not too far away. He was a real nice guy. And I had given him a pigeon one time, and he put in a race from Memphis, turned him loose, and the pigeon, instead of coming to New Orleans, it went to Pennsylvania, to a coal miner that lived right outside of Pittsburgh. And the guy introduced us to a guy by the name of Strasser, who was a good friend of John Mahaffey's. And they would send us the birds down, and Clem gave me some of those birds, and they were really the best of the best at that time. We won a lot of races with him, and he won a lot of races. But Strasser told us, he says, I send you the ones that didn't fly up here, but they were great breeders for you all. Mm-hmm. They were gorgeous pigeons, gorgeous.
Who helped you?
Well, I met Mike through Clint Thoman, and I was at college over here in New Orleans at Loyola at the time, and I used to forward the pigeons with Clem. I used to go over there and fly them and clean the lofts and stuff like that. And the ones he's talking about was Bastines, actually. And I remember one 500-mile race with the Bastines at Clem's house that we took one through five, first five places in the 500 with those Bastine birds. They were outstanding. They were really great.
And that's the same birds you're talking about,
yeah.
Mike.
Right. They were really great pigeons. They were without a doubt. In 63, Pete DeWeard came to town. And I brought my birds over to him. Let me preface this. I believe that Pete DeWeard was the greatest pigeon man I ever met in my life. He knew everything about pigeons. But anyway, he graded the birds, and these Bastines, and there were some signed Stassets mixed in with them, they were graded the best that first year down here. And the guy, I had given a couple of them to another fella that raced here, named Nick Sacomo. And first year in 63, I went and had mine graded on the first day he was in town. And the next day, Nick went and brought his birds. And DeWeard told him, he said, these are not your pigeons, they're Mailhes' pigeons. He could pick, he knew the type or something, how he did it, it was beyond my comprehension. But it was unbelievable. And he could look at a pigeon and say, that pigeon's got worms. And you take the pigeon home and dose him with some worm medicine, the next day you knew he was right. It's unbelievable.
Good, good pigeon man.
Oh, there was nobody close to him.
Well, you wait for me? Well, the guy that I can remember was, well, of course, Mike. Mike knows his pigeons. You could show him a pigeon this year and 5 years later show him the same pigeon and he would remember it. But I also was impressed with Art Hughes. Art flew some birds for me over in GHC, and he did well with them. And I just thought he was really a great pigeon guy.